Before the inception of life on our planet, gravity brought dust and gas together throughout a vast stretch of space to form the early solar system. The planets that we know today came into existence, along with the most influential part of them all, the Sun. This burning ball of light is the reason why we have life on our planet. Our biology is designed to cooperate with the Sun. It's no surprise that people have worshipped and revered our nearest star for centuries. Life emerged on Earth due to its unique relationship with the Sun, and that bond continues to influence us. Even though the Sun is at the center of our solar system, it nevertheless hides many secrets from science. Uncovering these riddles could provide insight into mysterious activities observed in other stars, and potentially provide us with priceless information. It is our curiosity which has led us to send numerous missions to understand the dynamics of one of the largest stars in the universe. The Solar Orbiter spacecraft is our attempt to get to know the Sun a little better. This spacecraft is a satellite jointly developed by the European Space Agency and NASA to observe the Sun. It is designed to procure detailed measurements of the Sun's heliosphere and also observe its polar regions. It made a historic close pass of the Sun on the 26th of March, 2022 and reached its first perihelion, the point in its orbit closest to the star. As soon as it reached perihelion, all the 10 instruments started operating in order to provide us with valuable data which is unlike anything we've ever seen before. Let's get you updated on some of the instruments, shall we? Solar Orbiter will collect data from the Sun in a variety of ways. It will be using its extreme ultraviolet imager for high-resolution observations, via which we expect to get a clear image of the Sun. The solar wind emitted by the Sun will be measured in real time as it passes by the spacecraft using its immobile instruments. Dynamic activity on the surface, such as churning sunspots, will be detected by full-disc telescopes. The narrow-angle imager will mark the observed places for future missions. No other spacecraft has so many advanced instruments, and that makes the Solar Orbiter one of the most revolutionary satellites out there. The Solar Orbiter is not the only spacecraft out there. It is joined by the Parker Solar Probe, which holds the record for the closest approach to the Sun. These two are meant to provide us with insurmountable information. On most days, our generally placid Sun goes about its job, providing a consistent and predictable quantity of heat and light to keep our planet and its inhabitants alive. But, just as the Sun is responsible for weather on Earth, solar activity is responsible for disturbances in our space environment. We need to keep an eye out on these disturbances as they may someday affect us. This is only the beginning. In the next few years, the spacecraft will go even closer to the Sun. It will also gradually elevate its orientation to see the Sun's polar regions, which have never been observed before. It's only a matter of time before our knowledge about the Sun expands. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments to let us know, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, your ultimate hangout for news from the world of astronomy.
In the beginning, there was nothing, or so the Big Bang theory suggests. And then, boom. The birth of our universe. Like all families, our solar system's members have a regular origin story. Only 4 centuries ago, Galileo discovered that the Earth revolves around the Sun and not vice versa. Now we know that the Earth does not revolve around the Sun. Technically, what is going on is that the Earth, Sun, and all the planets are orbiting around the center of mass of the solar system. As science advanced, we started asking the question, are we alone? This question alone has fascinated and disturbed us. So much so that we have launched space exploration programs to look at the universe through the lens of telescopes. And the agency leading the charge is NASA. One such development has been in the field of discovering new, habitable planets in our vast universe. There are countless number of unknown planets scattered across our universe. We have already discovered an astonishing 4,935 exoplanets, and recently, we came across 65 new planets that has taken our tally to 5,000. The latest batch of 65 exoplanets, planets outside our immediate solar system, were added to the NASA Exoplanet Archive on March 21, marking the start of the planetary odometer. You may be wondering how we're discovering these exoplanets that are millions of light years away from us. Well, thanks to the Hubble Space Telescope, we can peer into this extensive universe, and very soon, the James Webb Space Telescope will also join the mission after its mirrors are completely ready. These two have been vital for making important discoveries and providing priceless information about the cosmos. The JWST is the most advanced telescope ever made, and it is 100 times more powerful than its predecessor. With its help, we can unravel the secrets of this boundless expanse. We have discovered all kinds of planets, small, rocky worlds, gas giants, larger than Jupiter, and extremely hot, inhabitable planets. Out of all of these, there are a few planets that stand out. Kepler-1649c is one such planet. Its characteristics are very similar to Earth. In fact, this is the most habitable planet that we have discovered that may shelter life. Another such planet is Proxima Centauri b, located 4.1 light years from Earth. It orbits in the habitable zone of the red dwarf star, Proxima Centauri, which is the closest star to the Sun. Other exoplanets that are relatively close to Earth and may support life are Barnard Star b, Ross 128b, Lutton b, and Wolf 1061c. These celestial spheres can be considered a viable option if we were to ever go looking for habitable planets in the near future. Till now, we have been able to find 55 of these Earth-like planets. With the rate at which our technology is advancing, who knows what we might be capable of in the future? Wouldn't it be amazing to come across a planet that can sustain life? Our next goal, as of now, is to take life to the red planet, Mars. Thanks, Elon. At the moment, Mars is not habitable, as it doesn't have a magnetic field, and this factor is very vital for humans to survive on any planet. But this is about to change very soon. One way that we're considering to make Mars habitable is nuking the barren red planet. The heat produced by the nuclear missiles is required for forming magnetic fields, which in turn would help organisms thrive. Let's hope that we come up with an alternative that doesn't require such destructive measures. Mars was never going to be our final destination. This is going to be like our temporary home. The search for our permanent home is still going on. We're entering a new era of discovery that will go beyond just adding new planets to the list, and now that the JWST is finishing aligning its mirrors, we can hope to come across more celestial bodies. Every day, we are making new discoveries with our technology, but in order to succeed in space exploration, we need advanced technology. We will surely get there soon enough. It is predicted that by 2030, robots will start having a more dominant role in society, and by 2040, the robot population will surpass the human population. Robots and AI are vital for ensuring a future for the human race. We can assure you that in our search for a habitable exoplanet, AI is going to play a major role. But no matter what, the quest for the ultimate truth, are we alone? Should never stop. As Carl Sagan said, the universe is a pretty big place. If it's just a seems like an awful waste of space. So, let's take a journey into the future of space exploration and find what we're looking for, a new home by the light of our new sun.